Wait, I need a name for this character. What do I call it? So yeah, oh my God, let me do a pretext because this is also gonna be a YouTube video later on. So let me do a pretext for what I'm doing right now. Okay, so I bought this body pillow like in 2019. I bought this at Gamescom and I've been having it since then, but the other day I had a very great idea. What if I turn this body pillow into a 3D model? Now, I do have images of this. I also took the pillows out so I had like more flatter image. I feel like it's gonna be fun. It's not super like hard of a model, but it's just a fun concept to turn a body pillow into an actual 3D model. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. Alright, anyways, so I did take some pictures of it, and gonna just lay them out here. So I have probably making an outfit as well. It's not super hard. Alright. So, maybe I should have cut this out, but it's fine. Let me get the proper scaling for this. Ah, that's actually good scaling. What the hell? I almost got it right. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
I don't know why I bought this one. Did I want this? Appropriate music. I know the clipping, I just need to activate that, by the way. There we go. Seems appropriate. Oh, there we go. Look at this. Like, if you just add like tiny bit, if you add outline, basically anything that's underneath, it's gonna get blended that everything that's on top. So it's gonna make it slightly more darker. So look, I didn't have to like paint the inner side of this. It just made it slightly more darker and now it looks better. So like this is without it. I mean, there's not even anything. And then with it, and suddenly like they have volume now, right? Same thing like for this stuff underneath, right? Like it is slightly darker now there. And I could potentially make it even more darker if I wanted to. And then tint. Let's do 0.1 tint. It'll make it more like desaturated dark. There. I want this to be a little bit more saturated though. Something like that. That works. Yeah, that works. Somebody did ask me the other day, they were like, oh, do I have to make like two layers of this, of clothing? I was like, no, you don't have to. Just do that. I think I'm just gonna make it like less saturated, actually, like more like that. Yeah, that makes more sense. That makes more sense for everything. You can add some colliders and maybe it's gonna like make it less. It will make it less, but ultimately you can't do... If you want your skirt to be freely still like floating around in a... like live rendered model, it's very hard to make it in a way where like it's just not clipping permanently. It's very, very fucking hard to do that. It's very hard to do that without like increasing processing power. Let's just say like that, because that would require a shit ton of processing power because you're doing it live, right? Now, if it was like pre-rendered model, it would be much easier, right? Because on a pre-rendered model, it's pre-rendered, like everything is already rendered, so you don't have to like worry about it. Yeah, let's see like side by side if the difference is gonna be much here. We have same dances on both of them. I think if I also increase, let me increase collider on this itself. I'll make it like sort of like huge. Let's try that, I guess. I
I have to restart this. Alright, give me a second. Let's try that. Yeah, you see? Like, there's no clipping on right side. But there is some clipping on the left side still. I'll do it again. Yeah, there you go. So it eliminates some clipping, basically, as you can see. Yeah, colliders is the way to go, basically. So to actually demonstrate it without the other models, try doing it here. So that's the leg, right? Okay, see? So that's like a way better result, right? There's still gonna be some clipping, but at least like this is way better, right? At least like your leg actually reacts to this dress more or less. Yeah, with a tiny bit of clipping, but this is better. So yeah, you can get some good results, but again, they're never gonna be perfect, unfortunately. That's just kind of how it works. Right. I will make sure to have this model up on booth as soon as possible. I just need to do some testing with it, obviously, in VRChat and make sure that everything is fine. But yeah, I'll do like a couple of renders. I'll put it up there. Should be all right. All right, anyways, thank you, everyone. I'll see you guys.